Hi everybody, thanks for coming back to 1MinuteDigital.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make this bicycle chain graphic that you can use in badges or logos or as a border for a flyer design that you have. And we're going to make the graphic and bring it into our brushes palette. That means we can create a brush and use it over and over again, change the colors, customize it, do whatever we want to it in Illustrator. So let's make a new document. Just a letter size is fine. And we're going to need a few windows open while we're working. So go to Window, Brushes, it's our Brushes palette, Window, Stroke, and Window, Pathfinder. Have all these three windows open while you're working. Also, go up to View and turn on your Smart Guides. Make sure this is checked. It's going to help you align things perfectly as you work. Okay, as with most things in Illustrator, it starts off with a circle. So let's find our circle on our toolbar. Ellipse tool, hold down shift, click and drag a circle. Now go back and choose the rectangle tool, hold down shift, click and drag a slightly smaller square, not bigger, not the same size, just a little bit smaller than the circle. Now these are a white fill and a black stroke. Select both of them, now let's align them. Go up to the top here, you have alignment tools, click and hold, make sure align to selection is selected, choose horizontal align center, and vertical align center. And that puts them exactly one on top of another. Now hold down shift in the square, click and drag it out. And now we want to use our arrows to bump that a little bit back to where the center little square on that square is touching the line of the circle. That's about where we want them. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Okay, now selecting both, we're going to go to Object, Blend options. Change the number of spacing steps to 20. Make sure actually specified stepped is selected. Change the number to 20. Make sure that align to path is selected and say OK. Now go back up there. We have to do it in two steps for some reason. Object, blend, make. And what that did was blended our circle into the shape of that square. You can see it made the sort of melted circle shape. Select them again. Go to Object, Expand, say OK, and now go over to your Pathfinder that we opened up, and the first option is Unite. Click there, and now you can see it made it one shape, which is a white fill and a black stroke. If you flip these, you can see it, you can change it very easily. That's what we've made. Now, let's move it over. Now, holding down Shift and Option, you have clicked off of it. Hold down Shift and Option, now click on it, and drag it. That's going to create an exact duplicate and keep it aligned. And let go. There we go. Now select just the one on the right. Go over to your Reflect tool. It defaults to the Rotate tool. Find that. Hold down until you find Reflect. Now hold down Shift. Click anywhere in there and drag it slightly to the right. And that will flip it over. Now using our black arrow, click off of it. Now hold down Shift. Click on and drag it over until you see the intersect come up with your smart guides. That means they're exactly touching. That's where we want them. Now select both of them, go back over to that Pathfinder, and unite them again. And now we have one shape, as you can see, with a lot of little tiny anchors where it has created that shape for us. I'm going to make the stroke a little bit bigger so we can see it better. What I like to do at this point is to smooth these out. There's a whole bunch of anchor points there we don't need. So going over to your pencil tool here, click and hold and find the smooth tool. This is easier if you have a Wacom tablet, but you can do it with the mouse also. With that selected, we're just going to smooth, just draw right on top of there, and it's going to smooth these out and get rid of all these anchor points. There we go, it made it into four. And now we're going to do the same thing on the bottom. Just smooth it out, gets rid of all that extra stuff we don't need. There we go, now we have a nice shape that we've created in Illustrator. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to change this from a white fill with a black stroke to a black fill with a white stroke by just selecting it and flipping it over on your toolbar there. What we need to do is expand this now. We can't see that white stroke, we want to be able to see that white stroke by giving it a black stroke. And the way you do that is by selecting it, go up to Object, Path, Offset Path. It's going to ask you how much you want to offset it. You're going to want to play with these numbers here until you get something that looks like this. Just a little bit bigger than the stroke we already have, and you can see that here when it's selected. that looks good, we'll say OK. And now change it, just flip it to a black stroke with a white fill. And now we have a fill with a stroke and then a stroke around the stroke. And that's what we want. Okay, now we're going to draw a circle. Go find your ellipse tool. Hold down shift anywhere in your artboard. Click and drag a good sized circle. Make that a black fill with a white stroke. And make another one anywhere in your artboard, a little bit smaller. Select them both, and again, we're going to go to our alignment tools, horizontal and vertical. That gets them exactly one on top of another. I think those strokes are a little bit thick. I'm just going to bring them down a little bit. There we go. Now put it somewhere where it looks like it would be good for your bicycle chain. Group it by hitting Command G, or go to Object, Group. And that means when you select them, they're going to be grouped together. Clicking away from everything, hold down Shift and Option, and drag another one over. That's going to make an exact copy and keep it aligned. There we go. Now let's just make sure that they're aligned by grouping these circles, just those two, select them, and Command G or Object Group, and then group, select everything and align them yet again. So we make sure that we are exactly aligned. It's very important when making brushes that you keep everything very symmetrical or it won't look good when you create a larger shape. Okay, so now we've done that. Let's zoom out a little bit. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller so we don't go off the artboard while we're making this. Okay, now group what you have. Select everything and group it. Command G again. Click off of it. Hold down Shift and Option. Click and drag. Again, that made an exact copy and moved it over, keeping it perfectly aligned. Now we're going to create the link between these two by getting the rectangle tool. Click and drag doesn't have to be a perfect square, and we just want to make sure that that is going to tuck up underneath our links when we send it to the back. Okay, what we need to do also is to treat it the same way we did these links by expanding it. So it is a black fill with a white stroke. I'm going to make sure it's exactly the same as this one by using the eyedropper tool and just clicking there with that selected. That's going to make it the same stroke thickness. Now with just the square selected, go up to Object, Path, Offset Path. It's going to keep whatever you've kept for the last one, say OK, and then like we did before, just flip that stroke and fill so now it's exactly the same as the circle links that we did before. Send it to back by going Object, Object Arrange, Send to Back. Oops, you have to select everything, sorry, group everything. Object, Arrange, Send to Back, and there we go. And you can bump it up or down a little bit. It looks like it's a little too low. Selecting everything, just bump that up with your arrows. It doesn't have to be exactly in the middle, but there we go. And that is going to link our two bicycle chain, link the links, rather, together. Okay, now we have made our pattern that we're going to import. We're not going to import the entire pattern. We're going to import a section of it. So selecting everything, have your rulers turned on by going to View, Rulers, or Command R, which is what I'm going to do. Now I'm going to zoom in to a section. We're going to go into somewhere in the middle of our first section. Click and drag a ruler to one point until you see the word path. I'm picking this, you can't see it very well, but when you get there, it tells you you're there on the anchor and let go. Do the same, find that same point on the other shape. These are exactly the same shapes, remember, so we can find that same anchor. So this is what we're looking for here. It's about in the center, the little anchor there. Grab your ruler, find that same point till it says anchor and let go. Actually, I'll do that again because I think I moved it. There we go. Anchor, let go. Okay, zooming out. Now we're going to take a section of this. Get your rectangle tool again. Click and drag from guide to guide that you've made. Turn it invisible by getting rid of the stroke and the fill. We can't see it, but it's there. Now bring down our path and make it a snug little selection, getting rid of the extra space there. That's perfect. But now we need to send this invisible rectangle to behind the rest of our object. So go to Object, Arrange, Send to Back. Now that is behind everything. Now we're done. Select the entire thing, click and drag it into your brushes palette that we've opened earlier. Check Pattern Brush, OK. It's going to ask you for some customization here. The only thing I would do is actually change colorization to tints, that means you're going to be able to change the colors and say OK. Now we can get rid of this for now, just move it over. And anything we draw, holding down shift to create a circle, click and drag, get rid of the guides, choose a black stroke, no fill, and just select the brush we just made. And there we go. It's a little bit big, as you can see, so we can change how big those links are by changing the weight of our stroke. You can also double-click on that brush palette and bring your scale down to whatever it is you want. There we go. That looks pretty good. Say OK. And now we can apply this to any shape we make. The only thing I want to point out here, before we make some more shapes, is depending on how big the links in your bicycle chain are, you may get some overlap, as you can see here. Where it overlaps, it puts two, for some reason, on top of each other. So when you're done and you have your chain set the way you want, if you want to get rid of that extra little thing, with your shape selected, go up to Object, Expand Appearance, and that changes everything back into strokes and fills, and then you can just use your white arrow and get rid of those extra, that extra little shape there. And that's all you have to do. But wait till you're done, and then if there's any overlap, then you can delete them at that point. I'm going to put those back for now, change that back to a brush, and show you how you can make lots of shapes. You can even make a star shape and give it a chain. Looks a little bit weird, but remember, we can always change this by changing our stroke weight or going inside, double-clicking here, and changing this scale. Say OK. You can change the colors by clicking on it and changing the stroke color to anything you want. There you go. The only thing you can't change it to is white, because if you change it to white, all the details on the inside are also white, and you just get a blob that doesn't look like anything. If you want to make it white on the inside, when you do it, just start out and use white instead of black. Do everything we did here in reverse, and drag that in, and then you'll have a white one. And you can use those forever and ever, and make lots of great shapes like we did here. This is kind of a mess, but you can see. You can put them on circles and they stand out really nicely. You can just make a loose chain. You can even make letters, ovals, anything you want, just by creating the simple couple of shapes here and dragging that into your brushes palette. It's really that easy. I know that was a lot of steps to go over and a lot of key commands, but I want you to be able to make your own custom brush and make it look exactly the way you want it for your projects. Okay, I hope that was helpful for you, and until next time, bye-bye.